holy name.
Worship His holy name.
Worship His holy name.
Worship His holy name.
Our Lord and our Daddy, we worship you this morning. We worship you because there's none like you. You are the kings of kings. You are the lords of lords. You are the prime minister. You are the rose of Sharon. You are the lily of the valley. You are the Alpha. You are the Omega. The beginning, the end.
Thank you,
Jesus. You're only God that is, the one that was, the one that has to come. Father, we worship you.
Hallelujah.
Father, we worship you.
Amen.
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 Lord, I say be that glorified in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Our daddy and our call, we thank you again this morning.
Thank you, Lord.
We thank you for what you have done already.
Yes, Daddy.
Thank you for healing that taking place.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for deliverance.
Thank you, Daddy.
Thank you for miracles.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for signs.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for wonders.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for blessing.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for testimonies.
Thank you, Lord.
Our Father, accept all our thanksgiving.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, this morning we are here in order to hear from you. Father, speak to us.
Amen.
Father, speak to us.
Amen.
Today, Father, touch our life.
Amen.
Touch all our situations.
Amen.
Touch our marriages.
Amen.
Touch our businesses.
Amen.
Touch our job.
Amen.
Touch our career.
Amen.
Touch our ministry.
Amen.
Touch our marriages.
Amen.
Daddy, let it be so.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, blessed Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Lord, this morning, I hide myself behind the cross. I pray, Lord, this morning, I totally decrease so that you increase.
Amen.
Don't let these your children, don't let them see me, let them see you.
Amen.
Daddy, let it be so.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, I empty myself completely from whatever I've studied, I've learned. I pray, Lord, this morning, as I open my mouth, Father, feel it.
Amen.
Father, feel it.
Amen.
Father, feel it.
Amen.
Daddy, let it be so.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, blessed Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Devil, the God rebuke you.
Amen.
The Lord rebuke you.
Amen.
Every of your program that is contrary to the Lord's arrangement, we paralyze.
Amen.
We paralyze.
Amen.
We paralyze.
Amen.
Daddy, let it be so.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
At the end of everything this afternoon, amen, let only be glorified.
Amen.
Thank you, blessed Father.
Thank you, Lord.
As many of your children are still on their way, I pray that you cook in all their footsteps here.
Amen.
Lord, let it be so.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, blessed Father.
Thank you, Lord.
For in Jesus' name we are praying.
Amen.
I want somebody to say better, amen.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Let's set the ball rolling for these few minutes we have. Lord bless you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We started a topic last Sunday, but the Lord, tried a man with under authority of God. So God tells me to do, I do it. Mm-hmm. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
If I'm teaching love, say just keep short, stop it, mm-hmm, and let's do another thing.
Mm-hmm.
The one I want to do, I'm only somebody that's I'm really, I obey. So I've been trusting God for to continue. But Lord said, we're going to continue, but on the day, another dimension. So he remodified the topic. Instead of financial security, the Lord said, we continue on financial empowerment.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen. You see, it's the same thing, but it's better when somebody is empowered. Amen. It makes the job so easy. It makes your life begin to be start to bear fruit.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
People aggravate towards the success.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. That way I say the rich have many friends.
Mm.
Let's only shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We are going to see take our test from this test that we took last week. Isaiah 48. We're going to read verse 16 to 19. Isaiah 48, 16 to 19. Isaiah 48. I read from here, verse 16.
Come ye near unto me.
Amen.
Hear ye this. I have not spoken in secret from the beginning, from the time that it was. There am I.
Amen.
And now the Lord and his Spirit hath sent me.
Mm.
Thus saith the Lord, thy Redeemer, thy Holy One of Israel, I am the Lord thy God,
Amen.
Which teacheth thee to profit,
Amen.
Which leadeth thee by the way that thou shouldest go.
Amen.
Oh, that thou hast hearkened to my commandment,
mm-hmm.
then had thy peace been as a river, and thy righteousness as the waves of the sea. Thy seed also
mm-hmm.
had been as the sand,
yeah.
and the offspring of thy bowels like the gravel thereof. His name should not have been cut off nor destroyed from before me.
Amen.
Amen.
May the Lord bless his word in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Verse 17, he said, thus saith the Lord your Redeemer,
Amen.
The only one of Israel, who teaches you to profit, who leads you the way you should go.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We are talking about financial empowerment.
Amen.
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 In Psalm 62, verse 11. 62, verse 11. God said, he said, once he has spoken, twice I've heard that all power, including your finances, belong unto God. So that is why the Lord is releasing his power upon you.
Amen.
And the Lord will be, and shall be so in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let's open to 1 Chronicles 29. I'm trying to establish the financial empowerment before we go from where we ended last week for more clarity of the topic. 1 Chronicles 29, verse 10 to 16. 10 to 16. Is there? He said, wherefore David blessed the Lord before all the congregation. And David said, blessed be thou, Lord, God of Israel, our Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
Verse 11. See that, O Lord, is the greatness,
Amen.
And the power,
Amen.
Belong unto him,
Amen.
And the glory,
Amen.
And the victory,
Amen.
And the majesty.
Amen.
For all that's in heaven and in the heart,
Amen.
Is done.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
That is the kingdom, O Lord,
Amen.
and thou art exalted as head above all. Go ahead. See, both riches and honor come from who?
From God.
Come from God. So, and thou reign over all.
Yes.
And in thy hand is power and might. So, to finance, to empower financially, he can do it. Is that not so? Because Bible says he has a power and mind, and everything is in the hand. It is to make great. God is God that can make great. Amen. No one. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let's go to Psalm. Let's hold this one. Go to Psalm 75. Psalm 75. Psalm 75. We're talking about financial empowerment. 6 and 7.
For in the hand of the Lord there is a cup. No, sorry.
75, yes. 6.
For promotion cometh neither from the east.
Why does he come from?
Not from the west. Not from
Hello,
the south.
Sir. Hello, sir. Why does promotion come from?
From God.
From God. From God. Go ahead, sir.
From the west, no, from the south. But God is the judge.
Amen.
He putteth down one and setteth up another.
God does what? He putteth one down and
setteth
one up. Today is your day of lifting.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Because God putteth down one and lift another.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, somebody.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord, somebody.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Let's go back to our story that we're reading. 1 Corinthians chapter 10, 16. 10 to 16. Praise the Lord.
Go ahead.
Okay.
1 Corinthians 29.
13 now. Now therefore our God, we thank thee and praise thy glorious name.
Amen.
Verse 14. But who am I? And what is my people that we should be able to offer so willingly after this sort? For all things come of thee, and thy own have we given thee.
Amen.
Go ahead, go ahead.
We are strangers.
For we are strangers before thee, and sojourners, and where all our father, our days on the heart, are as a shadow, and there's none. Abiding. 16 by Nava. O Lord our God, all this store that we have prepared to build thee an house for thy only name coming of thy hand, and it's all thy work, their own. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Financial empowerment. Amen. Last week, I say, why do we need financial security? But because God has modified it this morning, the question now is, why do we need financial empowerment? We need to be empowered financially so that the end can come to every depth and financial limitation in our life. We need to be empowered. We pray that God has power to do all things. Praise the Lord. So for us to be empowered financially, to be, because in order to put an end to every debt and financial limitation. Let's open to Proverbs chapter 10, 22. Proverbs 10, 22.
The blessing of the Lord, it maketh rich, and he added no sorrow with it.
Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Proverbs 22, verse 7, again.
Proverbs
22, 7. Okay.
The rich ruler over the poor, and the borrower is suffered to the lender.
Amen, somebody.
Amen.
We need to be empowered in order to remove every form of debt and every financial limitation. Because Bible told me here, say the rich rule over the poor, and the borrower is a servant to the lender. The Lord will change our story this
morning.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Because you are going to be empowered.
Amen.
Amen. And God will change the order.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Again, why do we need to be empowered financially? Another point. Because God told me. So it is time for you to take a stand, because God said, you see, because poor and poverty shall not cease in the land. So what stand are you taking? Because God said the poor and poverty will never cease in the land. So Makale, you need to stay exception so that can be in the sight of the rich. Open to Deuteronomy chapter 15, verse 10 to 11.
Thou shalt surely give him, and thy heart shall not be grieved when thou givest unto him, because that for this thing the Lord thy God shall bless thee in all thy works, and in all that thou puttest thine hand unto.
16. 11, I mean. Say 11.
Okay.
He's saying,
and
for the poor.
Okay.
Look at it very well. Okay. For the poor shall not cease out of the land. So God, you need to be empowered, because God say here. Yeah.
Therefore, I command thee.
He said, for the poor shall never cease out of the land. Therefore, I command thee, say, thou shalt open thy hand wide unto thy brother, to the poor, and to the needy in thy land. That's where you can take exception. So, we need to empower, because poor will never cease in the land. The Lord will change your story in the name of Jesus. Deuteronomy chapter 15, 10 to 11. That's what we just read. Another reason why do we need to be empowered? Praise the Lord. We need to be empowered because money answers all things. Why? You don't say like this. It is because when you are having money, things become easy. When you are rich, it put end to frustration and burdens. Amen. You do things so easily. So we need financial empowerment, because money answers all things. Let's open to Zechariah chapter 1, verse 16 and 17. See, therefore, thus said the Lord, I'm returned to Jerusalem with mercies. My house shall be built in it, said the Lord of hosts. God is speaking to us in this church. And a line shall be stretched forth upon Jerusalem. Verse 17. Cry ye, saying, thus said the Lord of hosts, my city through prosperity shall yet be spread abroad.
Amen.
And the Lord shall comfort Zion.
Amen.
And ye shall shoot Jerusalem. Praise the Lord. Second Corinthians chapter 8, verse 7 to 9. Why do we need to be empowered? For money answers all things. See, therefore, as you are bound in everything, in faith and utterance and knowledge and all diligence and in your love to us, see that ye abound in this grace also. I speak not by commandment, but by occasion of the fullness of order to prove the sincerity of your love. Verse 9. For you know the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though he was rich, yet for your sake, because of you, yet for your sake, he became poor, that ye through his poverty, my word, might be rich. So, automatically, when you are not being blessed, it may be your fault. We are coming there. Praise the Lord. Because God will never lie. When God says, I want to empower you, amen, there's always a condition which we need to fulfill. So, if you are not being blessed, it's not anybody's fault, it's your fault. You might be the architect of your own predicament. Praise the Lord. Because God said, for our sake, he became what? Poor. Rich. So that through his poverty, we might be rich. Then, why are you not rich? Where are the unbelievers? Why are they getting blessed? What is going on? Amen. Where are you? God said he went to. He said the riches of the Gentiles is laid into the hand of the righteous. You put it there. But why are we not tapping to it? Praise the Lord. Lord, when I know Jesus. Let's open to 3 John chapter 2. You see, God said, below, I pray. God said, I pray for you that you may prosper. Amen. In all things, and being earth, he has also prospered. Praise the Lord. It's not that God is talking about empowerment from God. That will never have any sorrow to it. That's why God said, I wish about it that be in good health, even as also prosper it. That's God. What for us? Again, let's open to Proverbs chapter 14, verse 20. He's talking about this money answer all things. You must be rich. Somebody say, I want to be rich. I must be empowered. Because God is telling me here.
Wow.
He said the poor is hated even of his own labor. But the rich, how many friends? People are not getting close to you because they are not seeing the benefit of your going to church. But by the name of God that has asked, I decree that today your story must change.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hey, if they have not been going, you cannot see the difference. That's why they are not falling to the church. Amen. Praise the Lord. And they look at you and say, even I that even I'm better than you. Better forget this God. They told you. Better forget this man. I'm going to go and join ourselves. The poor is hated even of his own neighbor. But the rich have many friends. Your story has to change.
Amen.
You see, we are talking about, you see, this thing is meant for us. If you are not getting blessed, it's your fault.
Okay.
If you are this country, you are serving God, I say you are doing that thing. If you are fully serving and engaged to this God, your life will change.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. So somebody just say, call me around 6 o'clock and say, I say, what's going on? Why are you coming to the church again? I say, I have a lot of things to cover. You know, don't need to cover. You know how you come to this country? You know how you came? Why you abandoned almost 16 years? I said, I better change. It's not for me. You see, what we are telling you here is not for pastor. What we are doing here to secure your own destiny.
Amen.
Amen. You need to begin to ask God to help you. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Again, let's open again to Proverbs 19:4. Before we get to a case study, we look at that one and we go from there. Proverbs 19 verse 4. Look at it again. See, wealth make many friends, but the poor is separated even from his neighbor. Separated from their neighbor. Amen. Go and see most of go back to your country and see some of your friends. People that cannot even come close to you before. When they see you, they say, Esther. You are here. Because you see, God, the word of God is standard. Let's say, I will never, my word that has spoken to you, it will never go void. It will accomplish the purpose. Praise the Lord, somebody.
Hallelujah.
Riches are many friends. The Lord help us in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Then we are coming down somewhere now. I want to look at this case study. From that case study, we discover why people are not being empowered. Why the so-called Christians are still being oppressed. Why are we not taking charge? Praise the Lord. Then we'll see what we need to do. And God will bless you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let's open to the story of this woman. 2 Kings chapter 4. 2 Kings chapter 4. Verse 1 to 6. 2 Kings chapter 4. You all know the story very well. Verse 1 to 7. Okay. You see, now there cry a certain woman of the wives of the son of the prophets unto Elisha, saying, thy servant, my husband, is dead. And thou knowest that thy servant did fear the Lord, and the creditor is come to take unto him my two sons to be both men. Look at that story very well. This woman ran to the man of God. But she came with a petition. See, this is what I'm going through. But this does not to happen to because my husband feared the law and he served the law. So therefore, the order has to change. I said last week that whatever you did yesterday is what you are going to read today. So it's better you do it well today so that it can be better for you tomorrow. So, yesterday is gone. Today, it's a little bit of control, but not throughout. Amen, somebody. That's why I beat people. Not throughout. In a few minutes from now, anything can happen. I was saying unto a new Bible study. Amen. About my dad. We rejoiced over the night. We ate dinner together. Amen. We all went to bed. Suddenly, the night, the man shouted. That what's going on? For you know, she just silent. We are very young then. That is okay. You say, thought it's okay. But that's the end. Praise the Lord. But thank God you are still in God's presence now.
you can still make a change.
Amen.
So they can have a better tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
Amen, somebody.
Amen.
This man say, my husband, serve, fear God and serve him. That means the man sold a good seed. So Makale, I cannot be, my sister should not suffer.
Yeah.
Because my parents did what is right.
Amen.
Amen. Today is time for you to begin to make amends. So that whatever you sow now, if you don't reap it, you shouldn't come to reap it.
Mm-hmm.
Because you can't determine the outcome of any harvest.
Mm-hmm.
It's God that determines it.
Mm-hmm.
Some say, I've been giving. Who determines your blessing? It's God. I don't determine your blessing. Because I give also. I've been sowing. Who are you sowing to? To my pocket. Amen. So that your blessing can be enormous. Besides chapter 10, verse 1 told us. Praise the Lord. What is this?
Let's go to the chapter.
Chapter 11. Verse 6. Okay, you are there from verse 6. Okay. Thank you for getting it for me. Quite like. He said, in the morning, my brethren, sow thy seed. And in the evening, we do not thy hand. Don't hold you and say, I've been sowing. I spent all my time in the church. What we are benefiting now, let me tell you, is what we have sown in time past. That time we thought they had disturbed me in the church. You know, we did. We have a lot of programs.
Mm-hmm.
3 days during the week, about 5 times VG, men fellowship, women, every VG, vocal VG every day. Mm-hmm. We thought they had disturbing us.
Yeah.
Not knowing we are sowing a seed. Seed is not limited to the monetary part alone. Your time is a seed. If you can get to your office, correct time.
Mm-hmm.
Why are you coming to the God present community? I told somebody ago, they told me, say, Pastor, I only get stuck at work.
Mm-hmm.
I say, why is it only you? Can't you change your schedule, your shift? And after, you disappear. Amen, somebody. Just pray and say, God. I'm going to say, God. Nobody will hold me and say, it's Pastor. I will say my own. Amen. If you are giving me food, don't give me again. Praise the Lord. So that your destiny can be well, can be secure, your future. So that your future can be alright. Better year now. Can be better for you. For thou knowest not whether shall prosper. Do you know the word that can prosper? Do you know the time God wants to lead that blessing? Maybe that the time you hold your hand. And say, no, this one. I'm used to pay my mortgage this time. Ah, Holy Ghost, help me. And God's Holy Ghost will help you. And the blessings is coming. Like this. It's coming like this. And that they just say, today, Pastor, whatever you need, talk. Today, this one, I'm going to hold it. God say, hold it now. Praise the Lord. There's a story I had. Amen. There's a lady that been coming to a church. And she's looking for food of the womb. She always sits on a place in the church. On a spot. Every Sunday, she's only there. And we pray and say, God, answer me like Anna. Answer me. This man didn't want to, you know, go help us where we come from. America, you don't care. Amen. But where we come from, African man. The minute you get married, they ask us now. Brother Femi, sister from Kilo Shelley, what are you doing? Only go and see. Give us the time to really enjoy and say, You better do something before people put her eyes on you.
Yeah.
Better do it now. He came to her and said, "Yes, so they push you from Niji and sing for you. Better. Thank God for them. Who know? Do you know that we are going to have those delays from goodness to favor? 4 years. Favor to the twins, 3 years. Twins to the smallest or small one, then we are, you see another guy. Do you know, can you determine the time of the reaping? Nobody, it is God that does that. The lady was, had been coming to church consistently, but that Sunday was tired. She said, "Today, I'm not going." And that was, that's our, that was her day. Devil is a bastard. Tell somebody, devil is a bastard. Say,
devil will not get me.
In the mighty name of Jesus. Consistency. But that Sunday, devil, the day didn't show up.
And they were kind of the twins. Ah, this my daughter. This today's her day. Unfortunately, another person came. Lady came.
It's that was also trusting God for children. Was only maybe one day in the church. That one sat on the same spot. That one do well, thank God I saw her. Thank God you really the blessing of the twins upon her. That one carry the twins. Pray out somebody. Consistency matter for God and
power. I will get this one for you. Let me see what I get it for you. There's a lot of money here this month. God's going to shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We're going to get this one for you. For more clarity. What we are saying. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Let's open to Proverbs 24 verse 10. Proverbs 24 verse 10. Still going back to that our text. After that our story. Case study. Don't worry. You must stop on that. No, just give you one, then we stop because of the time. Proverbs 24, verse 10. It says, "If thou faint in the day of adversity, thy strength is what? Small." God blesses continuity. You see, God is a God. He's very straightforward. He's not a magician. Amen. If you do you go like this, God will give you this. Amen. Praise the Lord, somebody. Let me tell you, where you placed God yesterday is where He places you now. No two about it. Go and ask for anyone. When they ask you questions, say, "I've been going to church." Ask them. Why did you place your God? Amen. It's only God you can do business with and you can never lose. I remember seeing somebody that said, "Well, I've been doing with God, I've lost." No. Check the love that person. Amen. God said, "Bring all that to the storehouse. All that. And you cut it into half." God release that money to open account.
Amen.
That's not the touch. No touch. And the people don't want to hear that one.
No.
I was telling my daughter yesterday. Mm-hmm. I said, "Let's go to bank." Mm-hmm. You've been working now, little one, this guy is not to be your stuff. No, no more, no more, but no matter what. This one had it, we had to pay your tithe.
Yeah.
Amen. And that was what we agreed. Thank God he listened to me.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. With the money you're going to pay tithe this morning.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Because God saw my heart.
Yeah.
Because that was God telling me. Mm-hmm. You want to buy iPhone. Mm-hmm. But I want to buy iPhone.
Mm-hmm.
But I've been begging and say, "This one is too much. I'm using a low phone. Why are you going to high?" Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Let's stay with mine. Let me give you this one. Yeah. You want to throw down inside the ocean. It's okay, let's go ahead. Amen.
We go, you see, the riches, God will make you rich in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You see, why people negotiate? Because they don't have money.
Yes.
That's true.
How much is 750 iPhone? Hello. But we have to consider everything now. Life being is here. Oh, Benny, this is you. My daughter say, Daddy, no, I've never.
Promise.
I promise you. You promise me. My 18 by day. 18 by day. I have to get a good phone.
It's okay.
We went to everywhere. Amen. It's because of money. But because of that height, he has not given already, but he's here in the church. He's going to give you this one. The iPhone was $750. Somebody just called and say, I have that same iPhone. I'm going to sell it for you for
$350.
That was when I was discussed, when I was negotiating, because we go over the night. Holy Spirit, by the night. That was what he was telling me. He said, thank God you told your daughter. She listened to you. He said, I'm a God that walk ahead. And he did it. 750, 350 iPhone. I'm going to say, Bobo, by 6 p.m., we pay you cash. That's what God can do. It's when you play God one, you put it first. Amen. Sometimes they go, people are negotiating to make a fence in a house. Estimate a lot of estimate, 10,000, 12,000, everything, all the stuff. But because we are doing God's work and we are committed to His service, say, faith will see that has called you, for He will do it. See, when you see, when they saw the called man committed to His calling, being faithful to what God has given to him, God is bad. He's committed to do it for him. That's how he works. What people are saying, we are going to spend 20,000, 10,000. How much do we finish?
Less than 4,000.
4,000 to do the offense. God said, He teaches you to make profit. That's when you least, He leaded you the way you should go. Most of you are leading yourself. Can't you see what's going on in the church now?
Mm-hmm.
When we put our eyes on somebody that tried to play pranks with God.
Yeah.
Amen. God say, when they have started, nobody can stop me.
Yes.
What I decide to do, nobody, no devil nor hell can stop it.
Yes.
Say God is not ready. Mm-hmm. But this can only happen to somebody that is so faithful, so committed to his cause.
Mm-hmm.
But suddenly and suddenly, look at me, God, sin is working now.
In
view wisdom now, get to our own place.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Is that not so?
Yes.
I mean, that is how God told me that don't forget your covenant. Yeah. 3 months of praise and worship.
Amen.
I say, but God, it's when we close, I say, I know. God is the God of covenant.
Mm-hmm.
Say, my covenant, I will not break, nor alter what I've gone to my lips.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. You may call the man and say, God, you know I'm your servant. I say, don't forget. I say, thank God, but I also remind them. I say, Daddy, I'm going to forget. I say, I'm going to forget that one. Immediately you close on that building, just know every song you come like this, Tuesday is worshiping God.
Mm-hmm.
The last week, it's going to be a week of 1 million praise.
Amen.
If you have someone from Japan, go and invite them now.
Mm-hmm.
Different languages.
Mm-hmm.
Thank God, brother, my prince and his wife.
Amen.
Is number from Ghana.
Amen.
Amen. Number even from Iraq.
Amen.
God bring them here. Nobody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Somebody.
Amen.
Say, Iran. Or number from Syria. Amen. Somebody.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let's go back to that story that we are reading of that woman. It does mean to us this morning.
Yes.
I will just make sure I finish that story, give 1 point, then we stop on that one so that we can pray. We'll continue from that one next week. Elisha said unto her, you see, immediately he heard and he knew, you know that it's time for this one to be blessed because of the seed that the husband sowed. Amen. You see, your seed will only speak for you.
Amen.
Will only speak for you. Elijah said to her, what shall I do for thee? Tell me, what art thou in thy house? And she said, thy handmaid has not anything in the house, save a pot of oil. Go ahead. Then he said, go borrow this vessel. I brought all thy neighbors, even empty vessel. Borrow not a few. Borrow not a few. Blessing of God is not limited. Praise the Lord. It's God, it's blessing that go. And look at the way he blesses Abraham. Bible says he blessed Abraham. And Isaac also was exceedingly great. Then Jacob was exceedingly great. See, there's always an increase in blessing. I need to say that an harvest is only more than the seed. Only more. There's a level. He blessed Abraham, increasing in the life of Isaac. When he get to Jacob, Bible say Jacob was exceedingly great. Abraham was great. The other one was so greater. But this one was exceedingly great because of the seed that Abraham sowed. Abraham was saying, sometimes he could say, when you are saying, Abraham blessing Sama, hallelujah, Abraham blessing Sama, and I'm blessing the money. You see, when you don't do what Abraham did, you'll be seeking forever. Unless you do what he did. Amen, somebody. Because God is not respect of anybody. He doesn't look at your face before he blesses anybody. When he wants to empower you financially, if so-called pastor, amen, which there's no pastor in heaven, amen, praise the Lord. Thank God, we praise him in heaven. Someone going to be jobless in heaven. Better go and join the praise team. No preaching in heaven, no. But I can, I'm going to join the choir too.
Amen.
I don't want to be jobless over there. Somebody shout hallelujah. No preaching in heaven, no. Amen. Praise the Lord, somebody.
Hallelujah.
God is not the best of anybody. If I don't do what I need to do, and somebody that is coming up doing what's supposed to do, God will bless that person. God doesn't accept anybody. Amen, somebody. When thou hast come in there, and thou shalt show thy door upon thee and upon thy son, and shall pour out unto all thy vessels, and thou shalt set aside that which is full. So she went from him, showed the door upon her and upon her son, who brought the vessel to her, and she poured out. And it came to pass, when the vessels were full, that she said unto her, to her son, bring me yet a vessel. And he said unto her, there is not a vessel more, and the oil stayed. First, the Lord. And she came and told the man of God, and said, go and sell and pay thy debt, and leave from thy children. And thou shalt leave thou and thy children of the rest. You see, leave, that means is continuous. Blessing. Praise the Lord. Question is, as you close on this note for this message, how can my life, how can I be empowered financially? How can I be empowered financially? I'll give you one. By next week, break it down. You must be fully engaged in the Lord's service. Fully engaged in the Lord's service. Then the question is, how can I be fully engaged? I give you one point and I stop on that one this afternoon. Amen. If you look back to that story, you see, it's because the man of God that passed was fully engaged in Lord's service. That was why his wife was able to receive that kind of blessing. Praise the Lord. You must really engage the Lord's service. How? Is you have to invest in the Lord. You must invest in the Lord. Invest in the Lord.
praise the Lord.
How can I invest in the Lord?
No, how can I be engaged in the God service?
But how?
How?
You must invest in the Lord.
You must invest in the Lord.
How do I invest in the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
How do you invest in the Lord?
Uh-huh.
It's to seek Him first. To seek Him first in all areas of your life, including your finances. Praise the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Praise the Lord. Mm-hmm. Let's look at this. Matthew chapter 6, 19:21. I'm close on that. Fully engaged in the Lord. How?
Mm.
It must invest. Amen.
That is to seek Him first in all areas of life.
That is, you must seek Him first in every area of your life, including your finances. See, lay not up yourself treasure upon earth, where moth and rust dwell corrupt, and where thieves break through and steal. Verse 20. But lay up for yourself treasure in heaven, where neither moth nor rust dwell corrupt, and where thieves do not break through, nor what? Nor steal. For where your treasure is, there will be your heart. With your heart be also. You must invest in the Lord. You see, when you don't invest, you are not entitled to any dividends. Praise the Lord. When you invest in the Lord, then there are going to be a divine dividends. Lord help us in the name of Jesus. Let's rise up this morning.